our supervisors are required when they tour to ensure that staff have a proper uniform to include a vest. So if he's on duty and was seen by a supervisor that would have made sure he had a vest on, he would have a vest on.
And this is the court. That is not entirely responsive, although it is information, but at least to the question, can you tell whether there's a vest on by virtue of you're looking at it? You can't tell. And you're basing it on what the standard policy is?
Right. He does not have an outer vest. I can see that.
Okay, and then we're back to Ms. Shanahan with her direct examination. Okay, if we can continue playing. Major, has this video been sped up at all, or is it just choppy like that?
No, that's the way it plays. Anytime I review video, that's how it plays.
And you can pause it, that's fine. If you can tell, did you see where that officer was walking to?
He went, yeah, behind. The surgeon's office is back there, behind that door. I think I was wrong in saying it was the blue door. It's actually behind there.
It's down that hallway there?
Yeah.
Is that another entrance to the sergeant's office, or is there just one entrance down that hallway?
Just one entrance. That concludes the request for portion of time.
Thank you. Now, next, ladies and gentlemen, you did send a note out to the court. It's been marked C5 in evidence. Were we shown a transcript of the phone conversation between Tasha and Lakovian, May 4 to May 16, 2017? If so, can we see them again? The transcripts cannot be seen again because any transcript in that regard is not in evidence. You can hear a playback of S2, which is the recorded calls that the transcript corresponds to, and that would happen here in court. And if you want to do that, don't let me know now. I'm going to send you back into the jury room. We have another discussion I know we have to have to determine whether you want to follow up on that. C6 is a note that the court received. It says, clarification of charges. Are the charges related solely as to the contraband being brought into the prison with the intention to distribute? Did you hear the question? C6, I'll repeat it. Clarification of charges. Are the charges related solely as to the contraband being brought into the prison with the intention to distribute? The charges, ladies and gentlemen, are as stated in the jury charge that was read to you in the courtroom and that you have a copy of in the jury room. Those instructions have been prepared, albeit they are detailed and full of legal language to a certain extent, but they have been prepared after great work by the court and the attorneys. Any kind of clarification that would be intended to be provided to you would not make it any more clear than is already in the jury instructions. I'm going to instruct you to reread, if necessary, the instructions or the appropriate part of the instructions. Discuss it among yourselves. If you have further questions, please send a note out to the court. Now, C8 is a question from the jury. What were the defendant's scheduled days off from work? You may rely on the evidence that has been provided to you in the jury room as it relates to that question. That's all I can say about that. In regard to C4, where you requested to view S35 again, I had asked the forelady about how long that review was, and she answered me. I'm going to now, in a moment rather, send you back to the jury room while I discuss that point with the attorneys. But before I do that, is there someone who has to leave very soon?